What's up, guys? Old Ed Mike here, and welcome to my reaction and review for Monuments Lavos featuring Mick Gordon. Pretty sure that's the Doom guy. Let's go. You die. So, fair warning, I fucking love Monuments. They are way up there in the list of prog bands and djent bands, whatever you want to call them. The Amanuensis is one of my favorite albums of all time. I love that album almost as much as I love Periphery's entire discography, and Periphery's my favorite band of all time. However, I have issues with their other albums, mostly in like production and stuff. Still love the band, but that also means that I've got a pretty high bar for them. So I know they have a newer vocalist. I can't remember his name. I know him. I know who he is. I just can't place it. The name right now, and I believe one of the guitarists also left, which is gonna be kind of sad. So this, I think, is the most recent, some of the most recent stuff without him in it, I think. So gonna have to see how this goes. I guess maybe Mick Gordon will make up for it. I guess we'll find out. Make sure you spin kick that subscribe button, and of course come by the live streams that we do Friday night 7 p.m Central Standard Time. Let's listen to some Monuments with my headset on the proper way. Vocals kind of remind me of a lot of I Am Abomination. Phil's singing voice is very close to that. Andy, that's his name. Just popped in my head, sorry. That bass kick really hits. I like the production on the drums for sure. Pretty groovy. This guy really likes his high mids. Got a decent amount of groove in here.
Yeah.
the structure at the end breakdown. Okay, kind of creepy little video here. A little strange. Did it meet my expectations? Yes and no. I wish you would have done some more clean singing, personally. Very good clean singing voice. Like I said, reminds me a lot of Phil from I Am Abomination, another one of my favorite bands. I wish he would have done his vocal range a little more in the screams. He dipped down into that like flat mid for just a little bit, and I really liked that part. But he kind of stayed up in that mid to high range that was just kind of, I just want a little, you know, just a little bit of dip in there. You do miss a little bit of the groove from the previous releases. I think there was some sections in there where the guitar needed to be mixed up in the mix a little bit, that where it just had like that you know, the Monuments riffs where it's just like, but it wasn't up there. It wasn't the focus. It was like mostly the vocals, and the drums were up there. The drums were perfect. Nothing bad to say about that at all. I just wish there were some parts where the guitar, you know, when it was doing just a little bit of noodling, you know, they needed to bring that up, because that's, you know, that's a mainstay in Monuments music. Breakdown solid, because, you know, Monuments isn't a super breakdown band. They have like one or two breakdowns in a fucking album, but they usually make up for it with the groove, you know. That's what I love the most about Monuments, and especially Amanuensis, is it's so bouncy and groovy. Didn't have a lot of bounce here, but technically it's more of a heavier song, so it, you know, it kind of balances out. I can accept it. So not bad, not incredible. I would give this a 7 out of 10. 7 out of 10. I was thinking about going lower. I don't think it deserves to be lower, because, you know, there's not too many negatives. And it's, like I said, it's just a heavier song. I saw a ton of comments saying it was generic. I can see where they're coming from. Like I said, I wish he would have sang more. I think him singing more, bring that mix up a little bit for the guitar, make it just a little cleaner maybe, and would have been way higher, probably like a 9. So I guess we're just going to have to see what the rest of the album is going to be like. We had, what, one or two other singles that were really, really damn good, to be honest. Also, Mick Gordon, where was the fuck was Mick Gordon? Was he just playing, like, I thought he was going to do, like, maybe, like, a solo or something. Was he just doing rhythm guitar? I didn't hear him at all. So, very interesting. No information about the album, so stay tuned, I guess. Or check their Facebook, maybe. I haven't done research. So let me know your guys' thoughts on this. I'd be very interested in hearing it. I'm still looking forward to what these guys put out. They're a very underrated band, and don't have enough of a discography. They need more music. So yeah, 7 out of 10. Make sure you spin kick that subscribe button and come by my live streams that I do Friday nights, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. Other than that, that's about it. Old Ed Mike signing off, reminding you, never too old for this.